in this segment of DH Political Theatre, we're going to go to India's largest state geographically, that's Rajasthan, where we have Tabeenah Anjum waiting for us. Tabeenah, tell us, it's been another amazing victory for the BJP, 25 out of 25. Even they would not have imagined this, right?
Yeah, exactly. They never imagined this. I think it's a surprise for political analysts as well as BJP themselves. Even when I visited the BJP headquarters, I could hear people talking to me in the group like they never expected 25 out of 25.
So what trend went right for the BJP and what went wrong for the opposition? That they just won the assembly election there some time back. What's gone wrong?
Yeah, BJP lost the assembly election like 4 months ago and Congress won 100 seats out of 200. So Congress is pretty sure that they will be performing well. It's not like they get 3 for 25 seats, but they were eyeing at least 10 to 12 seats and BJP were eyeing at 20 to 25 seats. So even both Rahul Gandhi and Modi kept coming to Rajasthan. I think what strikes most was Modi's rallies in Rajasthan, where his stress was on national security, his stress was on nationalism, and I think Congress somewhere backed on it.
So, like in the rest of the country, we should not be looking at this as a referendum on the state government, but as a vote for Modi, right? Is that right?
Yeah, because like in Congress, where people could relate to the local candidates, in BJP, it was just about Modi. Everybody here voted for Modi more than the candidate. So, you know, just one unanimous name, Modi. And I think what went wrong again in Congress was the infighting in the party between the Chief Minister and Deputy Chief Minister.
Did Balakot play a big role in this campaign at all? Rajasthan, I think, is one of the states affected. Can you tell us a bit about that?
If we remember when Balakot incident happened, Modi on the same day came to Rajasthan's Churu, where he said Modi has a mumkin hai. That was the same day when Balakot airstrike took place. And you know, he went, which is known for the like soldiers and this thing. So I think it worked for people here in Rajasthan.
So can you tell us a little bit about big losers and big winners, surprise winners, surprise losers in Rajasthan this time round?
So when it comes to big winners, so it's all about BJP because all 25 teams have been by BJP. It's a landslide victory for BJP in Rajasthan. So out of 25 seats, the big winners are Rajavardhan Singh Rathore, who was fighting against Krishna Pugniya in Jaipur Rural. Then we have Rishan Singh Vasundhara Rajasthan, who will be the fourth time MP now. And then we have Priya Kumari, who made her amazing this Lok Sabha election for Rajasthan. And then we have all these three, Gajendra Singh Shekhawat, P.P. Chaudhary, C.R. Chaudhary, who were there in Modi's cabinet. They have also emerged as victorious. And one of the most surprising was the Alwar seat, where the priest Mahant Balaknath, who was there, he was fighting against the erstwhile royal, Jitendra Singh of Congress, and Jitendra Singh lost it.
Okay, and finally, Tabeenah, just a quick one on the chief ministership. Is there any talk of change at the top? Is the name of Sachin Pirate being mentioned? Is there any need for this?
Even I visited the BJP headquarters today, and later when I went to the Congress headquarters today, workers were talking among themselves that there could be possibility of change in guard in Rajasthan, but it's again a rumor. You know, there is nothing concrete on it because one cannot blame a single person here. It's like a whole scenario in the country going on right.
So great, Tabeenah, that's a nice roundup of what happened in Rajasthan, enormously important state, and 25 out of 25 for the BJP. So stay tuned for more updates on the elections as we wind down our coverage in the next few hours.
Thank you.